Planet of the Fakes 4 Families, and Pig Star HH News. For educational purposes, Warren police want feds involved in execution-style murder of 6-year-old boy to seek death penalty. Tyrez, 6, was found shot to death in the basement of a Warren home in an execution-style double murder. Warren, Mich. Fox 2, Warren Police Commissioner Bill Dwyer announced on Friday that he intends to ask federal authorities to get involved in the execution-style murder of a 6-year-old boy and a woman who police said is the boy's father's girlfriend. He said he wants federal investigators involved so the death penalty can be sought. Calling the murders truly evil and unthinkable, Dwyer said the person or persons responsible clearly have no regard for life. The execution-style killing of a 6-year-old boy is truly evil, unthinkable, senseless, and shows no regard for life. Only monsters and godless creatures would pull the trigger on a 6-year-old and execute a child, Dwyer said. Dwyer spoke during the 10 a.m. press conference to provide updated information on the execution-style murder of 6-year-old Tyrez and the woman, who has not been named. Police have said the woman is the girlfriend of the boy's father, who was found dead in a burned-up car on Detroit's east side early Thursday morning. Warren police and Detroit police are investigating the cases together, but the commissioner of Michigan's third-largest city said he's going to ask federal authorities to get involved. If we bring the federal authorities in, we may be asking for the death penalty for the person or persons responsible. I'm not saying we are at this point, Dwyer said. Following Dwyer's statement, he was asked again about the intentions to involve federal investigators and said it was necessary, considering the murder of a young child. Because we want the death penalty. When you murder a 6-year-old innocent baby, the person or persons responsible deserve the death penalty, he said. Dwyer added that they've had initial communication with the federal authorities in the U.S. Attorney General. The death penalty has been constitutionally banned in Michigan since 1963. Detroit Police Commander Eric Decker said the boy's father was shot to death before the car was set on fire. Detroit police officers then showed up at the home to notify the family of the boy's father after he was found in the burned car. The door was half open and looked suspicious, so they called Warren police. Warren police give update on execution of 6-year-old boy, 28-year-old woman. Warren Police Commissioner Bill Dwyer said they're asking federal law enforcement to prosecute the case in hopes that the death penalty could be sought. Dwyer said they are still investigating and have canvassed the neighborhood for witnesses and videos. He would not give more details on witnesses but said video would be released later in the day on Friday. He also urged people to come forward. There are people out there that's willing to see the news broadcast that all of you have out there, that they have the information. There are people that we know should come forward and provide us with the information to arrest the persons responsible. And I would plead with those people that have that information to either contact the Detroit Police Department Homicide Division or the Warren Police Department, and let's remember the 6-year-old baby that was murdered senselessly, and let's bring justice to the family. I think that those people that are out there that know who the killers are should come forward, Dwyer said. As for a motive in the murders, Dwyer said it's a possibility that it's drug-related, but said it's not certain at this point. He also said it's possible they knew the person who killed them. Dwyer said he could not confirm if the boy and the woman were tortured before they were killed. He said that information did not come from law enforcement and he could not confirm it. Neighbors told Fox 2 on Thursday that they watched police scour the home and neighborhood near 9 Mile and DeQuinder all day on Thursday. Fox 2 spoke to members of the family off camera who were too distraught to make a statement at this time. A GoFundMe was set up by Tyrez's grandmother to assist with burial expenses. Thank you very, very, very much. Go to www.